what happened in the last video.
Do you think that someone could get lost in this camp? Well, you know, someone else did like a day ago. So yes, I do.
And here is more MrDudeManSir.
I was so absorbed with my thoughts that I did not even notice how the darkness stole across the camp. Under other circumstances, I would have gone to sleep by now. But looking for Lena at night was such not a good idea. I got up and slowly wandered aimlessly. Soon the path led me to the sports ground. I stood there for a moment and was about to leave when I heard noises. Clap. Another clap. Something painfully familiar. Oh. Finally you're here. Where have you been? Oh. Oh yeah. This is something you guys don't know because I wasn't recording when I actually did this, the playthrough thing.
I wanted to get away. How could I ever lose in the first round? There was no excuse for me. The sports ground seemed to be the best place to go alone at the moment. Who would think about playing soccer in the evening, though? I sat down on a bench near the pitch and started to think about what happened. Suddenly, from the volleyball field outside, I started hearing sounds that seemed to me like sounds of rasping or whistling. Turning, I saw someone desperately swinging his hand. Who was he gesturing to? To my astonishment, it was Lena. She was throwing a shuttlecock up in the air and attempted to strike it with a racket. However, to be really, really honest, she sucked at badminton. I was just watching for a while, but then decided to go up to her. I went around the volleyball court and got inside of it so that she could, like, see me and stuff. Lena was timid as a deer, so I'd rather not repeat previous mistakes. Hey. She glanced at me and immediately hid the racket and the shuttlecock behind her back. You like badminton, do you? Well, not really. I see you're not really getting it. Maybe you want some help? To tell the truth, I was not very good at badminton, but just like any other child, I used to play it from time to time. Let me show you. Oh, thank you. And she blushed. I want to join the badminton team, but I don't see it happening, really. I won't even try today, but... She looked up at me. I never had any luck at cards, but seemed like I was on fire today, so I thought it would be the same with badminton. After those words, I realized losing to Lena is undoubtedly upsetting. I'd never think of you as being so keen on sports. She blushed again. Oh, excuse me. Come on, let me show you. I took the racket, threw the shuttlecock up in the air, and struck it with such strength that it flew over the fence and got lost among the trees. Oh, I'm sorry. Wow, didn't expect that for myself. Never mind. Although it was the last one. The last one. Let's go and get it. We'd better not. There is... in the forest. What's in there, a goblin? I laughed out loud. Lol. Well, maybe. He seemed like I was the only one joking around. There's no one there to be afraid of. Come on. Well, if you are with me. We went outside the sports ground and started to inspect the trees. All of a sudden, the screech of an owl pierced the night. Oh, Lena got scared that she seized me with both hands, giving me something like a hug. The strong grip was a bit awkward. To feel a girl's body and warmth so close to me, especially the boobs, it was tender. I had the desire to protect her and guard her from anyone, even if it's only an owl or another night bird. That owl looks great. It's holding the shuttlecock as well with this really tiny kawaii paw. My only wish was to let this embrace last forever. However, all good things must come to an end sooner or later. After a while, I realized that it was an owlet who had screeched to a branch next to us. It was holding our shuttlecock very tightly. That could be taken many ways. Is that what you were scared of? Take a look, it's not even scary at all. Lena looked out from behind my back. You're right, it's not scary at all. It's actually quite fabulous. Hey, wait a second. I gently got out of her hug and came close to the owlet. At first it seemed like it'd get frightened and fly away after dropping the shuttlecock. But the owlet was still perched there. I succeeded in grasping the shuttlecock and carefully taking it from the bird. Hey look, it's almost tame. Would you like to pet it? Maybe some other time. I just handed the shuttlecock to Lena. Why, thank you. She smiled gently. I have to go. Goodbye. Lena smiled again and hurried away to the camp. How sweet can a girl get?
I ran towards the volleyball court and saw Lena, who was unsuccessfully trying to hit the shuttlecock with a racket. I stood in shock for a long time. My head was completely empty, and I just looked at her and felt a sense of joy. Joy at finding her. Joy at seeing her again. Finally, I came to my senses and decided to approach. But after a couple of steps, I stopped. And what do I say now? I'm glad I found you. Where have you been? I was worried. After yesterday's conversation, it's very unlikely she wants to see me. And what if Lena asked me why I was looking for her? Why I was worrying? I did not know why myself. Probably it's because she was absent for too long. Maybe it wasn't her, but some other person who I'd known that would have worried the same way. Maybe if I behaved differently yesterday, she would not have been disappearing today. I'm not sure, but I'll try to come up with something adequate. I took another step and stopped again. Probably, maybe, perhaps, not sure. Again and again, these words appeared in my mind and my life. Unconsciously, without my will. But why? For what purpose? I had to make my decision once and for all. Although, there are two simple words, yes and no. Finally, it's all clear. I went to the court, approached Lena, and smiled and said, "Hey." She turned and looked at me. "Hi." "You were absent all day." "Yeah, I was walking around." Everything she said was quiet and calm, no trace of embarrassment or shyness. With no emotions at all, in fact. "We were worried about you. Though the only one who worried was me. You shouldn't have. But you can't just disappear like that." I tried to smile and make my words not sound like a reproach. I don't think that anybody cares about that. I care, for one. Why? I read surprise in her eyes. Because it's not right. No matter how I tried to be perfectly honest, it came out wrong. Ah, I see. Okay, I won't do this again. It seemed like this conversation was not interesting to her. Silence followed. I just didn't know what else to say. Lena seemed to be quite content in silence. "Are you any good?" I finally said, pointing at the racket. Not very. "If you want, say." No, I don't. She walked to the bench and put down her racket and the birdie. Okay. To tell the truth, I did not expect that response. Want to start at the stare at the start? Oh yeah, that's what they did. No, I'm confused myself again from the previous time we were here. But hey, let's stare at the stars together. Yeah, of course. I sat down beside her. Lena intently studied the sky. Lots of small lights shined above me. Some of them were brighter, some of them barely visible. I still don't have eyes, but I never really understood what people see in just sitting back and looking at the stars. After all, here on Earth are just small dots of light, and it's unlikely to many people to know what kind of celestial bodies they are, as well as their size and how far they are from us. Of course, it's so romantic as to enjoy the light and distant stars, but for me, it was like staring at a brick wall. And also had to be potholes and unevenness in the brick world. Brickwork, patterns of the stone. A stellar sky in miniature. "So what do you see there?" "Stars," she said mysteriously in her head up. "Yeah, I know, I see them too. What's so special about them?" "I don't know. It seems that they talk to me. There are other people there. They have their own life, probably much better than ours. And they look too like the sky and see Earth and me and you. Voice of the distant stars." I had already heard that from somewhere else. "Yeah, you can call it that." "An interesting theory." No, the theory is quite common." Lena looked at me. In the dim moonlight, I noticed a small tear rolling down her cheek. Or at least I thought I did. "I guess I'm just the more, let's say, practical person." She said nothing, just stared at the sky again. "But if you think about it, of course, there's endless interstellar space, millions of planets, hundreds of galaxies. It's fascinating." My voice sounded unnaturally excited. "You don't need to talk about all these things." "About what?" "About this. About everything." "No, the stars are really beautiful." "Why did you come?" Now she was crying for sure. I was looking for you." "Why?" "I didn't know why, I just was." "You found me, you happy now?" "Well," I mumbled, "why didn't you go to Alyssa? What does she have to do with it?" "You're trying to say that it's not about her?" "Yeah, that's exactly what I'm saying. Why did you bring up this topic again? I thought we'd already cleared everything up." "Of course we didn't clear anything up. To be precise, we didn't even start to. However, I don't understand why all this is necessary. You think I really want to talk about it myself? If you don't, then why? Because... It's because of you. Because of me what? You and Alyssa. Me and Alyssa what? We don't have a relationship. We don't have anything at all. Don't lie to me. Lena turned away, sobbing quietly. Why is this so important to her? What else can I say if you don't believe me? Tell me the truth. I already told you. Then go to her. Why should I go to her? I don't even go anywhere. Why are you sitting here and torturing me? Oh Lord, how am I torturing you? Lena didn't answer. I've been looking for you the entire day because I was worried. I came here because you're here. I'm sitting here because I want to be here. Don't you understand? She stopped crying for a moment. Is that true? Of course. I mean something to you. Even taking into account all these things you just said, the question came to me unexpectedly. Well, yeah. If only you could hear yourself now. She cried, got up, and walked briskly towards the exit of the sports ground. Wait. I caught up with her and grabbed her arm, but she pulled out of my grip. Don't touch me. Elena was a totally different person. I couldn't say she was aggressive, assertive, or strong-willed. She had no doubts about what she was doing. Wait. What did I say? It's all true. Save all this nonsense for her. I tried to stop Lena once again, but she stared at me so strongly I did not dare to argue. Just imagine how I feel. You make up a bunch of stupid things and now you think that I'm guilty of all mortal sins? Why should you care? I should! She stopped for a minute looking at me. It's all lies! In my anger, I banged my forehead on an iron post. You can't just beat yourself up here. I had seen Lena be many things, but not ruthless and indifferent. Wait, let's talk calmly. We have nothing to talk about. She crossed the football ground and trailed behind, trying in vain to persuade her to listen to me. I don't know why I'm doing all this, to prove that I'm right? So that I won't be misunderstood? So we look better in her eyes? Or is there some other reason? In any case, at that moment I just felt that it was unnecessary. We came to the square. Lena was pretty fast, I could barely keep up with her. I had to say something, my head was filled with different options, but nothing suitable. Wait! No answer. Listen, no answer. Will you stop it? No answer. We'll make up the whole camp. And so what? What's the difference? Strange, but at that moment I was more worried about the behavior of Lena. She stopped. Thanks for accompanying me. I'll go alone now. Lena said bitterly. You haven't listened to me yet. To me, it seems like I've already listened, several times even. So what do you want from me? Me? Not from you. Nothing at all. She sounded more confident than me. There was no trace of doubt in her eyes. What can I say? What can I do? Dang it. I was really about to burst into tears. Don't get so emotional. Nothing happened. Nothing happened. Something definitely happened. You won't lose anything if you pay no attention to me. Let me decide that. No, seriously, why? There are so many pleasant activities you could choose to do. Well, to be honest, I don't need it anyway. If you don't need it, why do you constantly mention Alyssa? Lena's face changed. That's none of your business, get it? No, now it's my business. She looked at me as if she's already ready to kill. Why are you bothering me? You have her, go to her. She won't refuse, I assure you. Lena started screaming, her hair dishevelled, her face flushed and her eyes bloodshot. Calm down, I won't go to her. Why would you even think so? You see, I'm here now and I'm not going anywhere. She seemed to calm down a bit. What's going on here? I turned around and saw Alyssa lazily chewing a bun. In the wrong place at the wrong time, the situation is a perfect example. I just froze in surprise, not knowing what to say. But Lena was smarter. Time to pass him on. Catch. Alyssa looked surprised. No wonder she hadn't heard the entire conversation. What? I said catch. Within a moment, Lena became like she was before, calm and unruffled. Why should I catch? Him. She pointed at her finger at me with disgust. He complains about how he loves you, and he cannot live without you and stuff like that. What? Alyssa's eyes popped open wide. No, that's all wrong. Lena's just joking. I giggled nervously. Why, that's exactly what's happening. Listen, everything has its limits. I said quietly to her. Do you want there to be victims? Why, I already suggested to you to go to her. I don't know what you're talking about here, but don't involve me. You don't know. Lena said it softly, but her voice was tracing rage in it. The same thing again. Alyssa looked at her frightened. Listen, I understand you, well, but I don't know, really, not a single word, not even a single thought about him, I swear. You don't know? Oh, man. Lena jumped at her, and before I realized, smashed Alyssa with a powerful right hook. Well, I'd understand a simple slap, but now it's just a blow to break someone's jaw. Alyssa clapped and seemed to lose consciousness. What should I do? Oh. Oh dear. Well, I don't want to screw up no route problems or anything like that, so I'll just go do this real fast. And then, you know what? I don't care what's happening right now. I'm not just not going to interfere and let Lena do that. I'm going to help Alyssa, of course. What are you doing? I don't care about any relationship problems that she has with Alyssa and me, but I'm going to help her. I ran over to the fallen girl and tried to figure out if she was alive at all. Are you completely out of your mind? If you want me to leave to shut up or do anything else, fine. But this is turning into a complete madhouse. Maybe you need the straitjacket so no one else will get injured. Lena stood, clenching her fist. You could even break your hand with such a blow. You don't understand anything. The tears welled up, flowing down her face, and she fled from the square. It seemed to me that I still couldn't hear Lena sobbing when she was bringing Alyssa around. She finally came back to her consciousness. You alive? You okay? Alyssa moved her jaw from left to right. I'll live. I helped her up. I told you about her. Well, that doesn't matter now. You have to get to the infirmary. It's too late for infirmary. I'll have a good night's rest in the morning. I'll go there. Okay, then I'll go with you. I can't refuse, Alyssa said, trying to give me a smile. All the lamp, he kept silent. She's probably not really able to talk. I couldn't find the right words to say. All this was a real shock for me. I found myself a mere spectator of a drama in which I just took the main part. After the door closed behind Alyssa, I stood for a long time and looked at her cabin. What should I do after all this? Fatigue overcame me. I had to sleep. I think Lena is now in a state in which she is unlikely to adequately assess reality. Completely broken, I fell down into the bed and drifted to sleep. Somehow, I woke up in my apartment. I didn't trigger any emotions at all, yet another day of my life, that's all. I got out of bed and went up to the computer. The message window flashed on the taskbar. I sat down and stared at the monitor. Somebody wrote to me, and that means somebody still needs me. The message contained only two words, wake up. What do they want from me? An unknown ID? Is that spam? What does it mean, wake up? I'm not sleeping anymore. The window still kept flashing. I tried to close it, but failed. Instead, yet another one popped out. Another one and another one, and all of them contained the same wake up. What the heck do you want from me? I screamed. Soon the whole screen was blazing with identical messages. I couldn't bear anymore, I grabbed it and smashed it against the wall with all my strength. A phone rang. Strange, who could that be? I picked up the phone and just heard, wake up. On the other hand, thousands of voices, men, women, children, were screaming, wake up. I smashed the phone on the floor, but it didn't break and kept ringing. In a moment, the whole room was filled with strangers. They were grabbing my hands, peering into my eyes, and screaming, wake up. I jumped off my bed in a cold sweat. Huh, what a dream. I came to my senses in a couple of minutes and took out the clock. That's 5 p.m. How long have I slept? All of the events yesterday flew through my head. Searching for Lena, the devastating conversation, Alyssa defeated. I really have to talk to her. Maybe she'd cool down overnight. I dressed up, went out of the cabin, hesitated a little while gathering my thoughts, then headed to Lena's cabin. What shall I say? How do I begin the conversation? I can't just go with, hi, how are you? I was just passing by. There's no way I should lecture her straight off the bat. Not reaching a specific solution, I knocked. Nobody answered. I knocked again, then pulled on the doorknob. It's not locked, that's odd. However, there was nobody inside. Well, that means Lena's not here. I'll grab some food I might find her at the canteen. Going along the rows of cabins, I didn't meet a single pioneer. That's odd too, it's always crowded here at this time of day. Nobody was at the square either. Coming up to the canteen, I started to get very seriously concerned. It's time for dinner, but there's no sign of hungry pioneer crowds. If only it was just that. The canteen was closed. Looks like something had happened during the day. I sat down on the porch and started to consider the situation. All the pioneers were gone, without any warning. Well, of course, it's hard to say that the camp of or my way of arriving here is normal, but I hadn't encountered any completely inexplicable stuff during the week yet. There were lots of strange things, but maybe they're hiding in that bunker, I chuckled aloud. While all this is very, to put mildly, mysterious, I was nowhere near the experiencing a panic attack. No, it's just that they have left. I almost jumped out of my skin. Lena was standing next to me. You can't just sneak up on people like that. You nearly gave me a heart attack. Sorry, she said calmly. Now her words dawned on me. Left. Hold on a second. What do you mean by just left? The session's over. The camp leader? She had some business to take care of in the town, so she went with them. Okay, what about you? I stayed. Lena was taking in the complete calmness, talking with complete calmness, as if everything that happened is completely normal and routine. How? Why is that? What's the problem? When the session is over, the children depart from their homes, don't they? And when was it decided that today is the last day of the session? You won't believe this, but on the very first day. Moreover, Olga Michelle announces that they can't line up. Yeah, even at those lineups I attended, the last thing that crossed my mind was listening to the camp leader's announcements. Then why didn't anyone tell me anything? I've waited for a chance to get out of this dang camp for so long, and when it finally appeared, I obviously slept through it. Well, that's exactly my style. I asked him not to. And if you would ask not to, Olga? Hold on, what? I asked for it, said Lena with the same confidence. And what, you asked them to leave me behind too? Yes. You don't think that's a little... absolutely wrong? I started shouting. No, it's perfectly normal. I took a good look at Lena. Not a single emotion across her face since the beginning of our talk. Looks like the girl that's standing in front of me right now was the kind of girl that's afraid of crickets, blushes at every occasion, and reads romance novels. Okay, I got it. Looks like the situation is directly connected to my mystical arrival at this camp. Just, who are you? Me? This morning I was Lena, she replied patiently. Oh yeah, and I'm Optimus Prime, born 9 million years ago in the highlands of Scotland. I wasn't afraid of her or anything around myself that moment. I was just bursting with anger from within. Nice to meet you, I'm Lena. Okay, now let's get serious. I think that's what you're saying is frankly impossible. Today, as it turns out, is the last day. Somehow I don't think anything about it, and the camp leader departs with everyone, leaving me behind just because you asked for it. Do you find that somewhat abnormal? Maybe I do. Are you hiding something? Maybe I am. And spit everything out you got. I told you already. I buried my face with my hands and took a deep breath. Okay, what am I supposed to do with this situation? I don't know. What are you going to do? I don't know. I'll go with the flow. Well, here's the flow. I hissed, abruptly spreading my hands. Why are you worried so much? For the first time, a flicker of interest had appeared on her face. And how do you expect me to feel? Glad? Well, not really, but you yourself wanted it. Me? You're mad! And who you said yesterday, and who said yesterday that he cares about what's going to be with me? That's what got you to do this? I pretended not to understand, but it's finally starting to dawn on me what she was driving at. Your wish was granted. Yeah, sure. I mumbled under my breath. Well, here I am with you. That doesn't explain in any way what happened. There's always a couple of tricks that could get one to succeed. And you... that is how... yeah. A smile crossed her face. If I'd known that you were so cunning from the very beginning... to tell the truth, I was kind of like this whole situation. Well, not really like, but I was curious. Of course, I'm very sorry that I couldn't have escaped with someone else. With everyone else. However, I'm having a that with Lena right now. That might mean that I'll get a chance to see her real her later. And all the answers that I was longing for could be right here, and not in some sort of mysterious town which everyone headed for. Okay, so what are we going to do now?
We?
She smiled.
Yeah, we.
We're the only ones staying here. The canteen's closed and I seriously doubt there's any food left here anyway. Of course, Olkan Mitrianda should return in the foreseeable future, but...
well, it doesn't matter.
Okay, it doesn't matter. Any suggestions?
What do you want?
She asked with a sly smile. I would have grabbed anything to eat, but now I don't know. Well, let's go and have something.
Where to?
There will be some food left in my cabin.
Okay, deal.
He went in and Lena rummaged around the desk drawer.
Well, there are cookies, want some?
She handed me a half-open bag of biscuits.
Oh, how cute,
I sneered.
Why?
The biscuits. Like in my childhood.
Yeah, I guess.
She smiled and sat next to me.
Well?
I asked with my mouth full.
What?
So what are we going to do?
I don't know.
She wistfully gazed out the window.
Well, what do you want?
But really, what do I want? A mere half an hour ago, my only thought was to get away from this dang camp. But now, right here, next to her, something seemed to change.
Well, I don't know either.
Think harder. She drew herself closer and gazed into my eyes.
Well, you know.
My face was blushing, my mind was racing. And that's because I was in extreme proximity to a girl that's quite clearly won something from me. But mainly because the girl was Lena.
Well,
she studied me closely.
Lena,
What? To say that she didn't look like herself was nothing. I was not afraid of this metamorphosis at all. Rather, I was afraid of myself. What could I do in such a situation?
Didn't you want to be with me?
She whispered into my ear seductively.
I did.
I do.
Then what's the problem?
You know, it's also... Besides, I have some other circumstances.
What circumstances?
She pulled away from me.
Well, various circumstances.
You don't prefer, do you?
Lena laughed.
Heck no. How could you think that?
Looks like I blushed even harder.
Then what's the problem?
Are you sure that you want that?
I tried hard to change the subject. After all, just a week ago I had my own normal life. A life where everything was strictly tied up and well organized. And where there was no place for girls. And now I'm in some kind of mysterious camp with Lena sitting next to me and hinting towards something. How should I behave in such a situation?
Yeah.
She frowned.
Of course I do. What's the problem?
Well, it's my... I was behaving like I wasn't 17, which is how I look now. As if I was even younger.
Mine too.
She smiled. I had to decide what to do next. Now, after the session was closed, all the pioneers were gone. I had to seek the answers. Above all, I just had to be aware that this girl could change her behavior and even character so easily at will. But at that exact moment, I was possessed by one thought.
Oh, what the heck.
Well, if you don't mind. I closed my eyes. She said nothing, just smiled and moved even closer. Our lips locked in a long kiss. I forgot everything at that moment. I forgot about this weird camp. I forgot about the local pioneers that were in fact gone. I forgot about a wacky camp leader. I forgot about my past life, about my future. If it would even come. Right now, the only thing that mattered was Lena. Her soft lips, her warmth that poured deep into my soul, burning from the inside. I gently moved to her side.
Hold on. Don't you think this is way too... fast?
Why? She smiled and looked at me in such a way that I immediately felt the adrenaline in her eyes.
You sure, aren't you?
I am. I whispered quietly.
Oh dear. Oh dear. Oh my gosh. Oh wow. Well then.
When I woke up, it was cool. Yep.
I got out of bed, put on my trousers, and headed straight around. What was that?
It's an animal instinct, Why? Chase guy, more bye.
What was that? Wow!